So I'm hanging out with my buddy Artur, and he's like, Dan, what would you do to make a faster CDN, content distribution network? And I'm like, well, I'd probably figure out a way to leverage DNS because it's all over the place and it caches. Guy goes, yeah, it caches. That means it's going to return old and stale data. And it's not like DNS lets you like update things. And I'm like, actually, it does. There's this trick from my talk last year that lets you say, I know you were returning this information, but now I need you to return that information, even though the old stuff has not yet expired. DNS is the internet's 411. Telephone network doesn't work on names. You gotta have numbers. But the numbers keep changing. So you're constantly going to DNS and being like, hey, what's the latest number? So if you send out a request, you get a reply. How do you link the requests and replies? Well, they would have transaction numbers. You still have a 16-bit transaction identifier, which is like a lottery where your odds of winning are 1 out of 65,000. But let's say you can only play the lotto once a day because the cash time is set to 1 day long. Ah, now, to win that lottery, it's gonna take 87 years. That's a decent amount of security. What it doesn't apply to is if you're looking up 1.google.com and 2.google.com and 3.google.com. Those are unique entries, or what's called sibling names to www. And if you ask a name server to look it up and say, I am the official server for google.com and let me tell you what www needs to be. And the server will go, you are the official. Go right ahead. Tell me what it's supposed to be. This is great if you're building a content distribution network, but it doesn't just make it faster to like make the internet work. It makes it faster to override everything. It makes it faster to take that 87-year delay. Now it's like 10 seconds. Actually getting full built out took 2 days between finding the exploit and realizing it worked on every name server on the planet except for one written by this obscure professor DJB who told us not to make this mistake in 99 and no one listened. We were really concerned about web pages and emails because that's what you get to compromise when you compromise DNS. That's the obvious stuff. Oh, you think you're sending an email to IBM but it really goes to bad guy. So I call up Paul. I'm like,
dude, here's the exploit. It works really quickly and it works everywhere.
He just sort of listens and then it clicks in his head what exactly I'm doing. And he goes,
okay, I need you to never tell anyone about this on an unencrypted phone line again.
And I'm like,
are you serious?
He goes,
that's what I'm asking.
And I'm like,
well, you're going to go handle getting this done, getting this fixed.
He's like,
okay, I've got a whole bunch of people. They're going to get on a plane. They don't know why.
Like,
you're getting people to fly without knowing what the problem is.
Goes,
yeah. What?
I mentioned Paul Vixie's a badass. So we have this giant secret meeting at Microsoft headquarters. And in fact, Paul Vixie goes up on stage in front of everybody and says,
we really should have listened to Dan Bernstein in 99.
Most humble thing I've ever heard someone say, but I was like, oh, jeebus, this must be bad. So I get up on stage in front of all these guys, and I'm like, look at this, watch this thing, blows up in front of everybody. And we all agreed that we would get it fixed in time for Black Hat. So it was a very interesting experience. But it's not like we repaired DNS, okay? We took a 16-bit transaction identifier and we used some UDP source ports as a hack to get a 32-bit transaction identifier. An attack that used to take 10 seconds now takes hours or days or weeks. That's not eliminating the attack. That's eliminating the instantaneous attack. There's a difference. We made the internet less flammable. The internet was never designed to be secure. The internet was designed to move pictures of cats. We're very good at moving pictures of cats, but somehow like the global economy has moved into our world. And we're just sitting here like, man, we built this in 1983. We didn't think you'd be moving trillions of dollars on this. What are we gonna do? And here's the answer. Some of us gotta go out and fix it.